Hey guys, how we doing? Goat from Goat's Firewood and Farms. Got the guys two behind me. We already got it notched. I forgot to hit the record button. So we're gonna knock it over, buck it up, maybe hit a couple more little ones, and I seen a really nice buck this morning, so we might go buck chasing and put firewood bucking. Alright guys, hang tight. I got the 660 warmed up. Let me get it running and I'll turn you back on. Alright guys, let's drop a tree. This is a G660 ported by Aaron Lynch. Built by Aaron Lynch. Bad boys. Alright, let's buck this thing up. 28 inch bar, full chisel, full comp. Alright guys, I went ahead and I marked a few rounds. We're gonna buck them and then I'll show you how I've been marking them here lately.
Shame these old ash trees are dying. That's a, and really that would have been a nice piece of wood. The beetles killed them all, but we got some more bucking to do. I'll show you how I've been marking out the logs here lately. Get some, I mean, pretty close. Not saying I'm down to where I can use a tape measure and say, hey, they're all the same size, but it stacks well. All right, guys, so what we have here, this is a G660, MS660 clone, ordered by Aaron Lynch. If you guys aren't a member of his channel, go check it out. Awesome guy, hell of a saw builder. That is a 28-inch bar, steel bar, not a lightweight, just a regular bar. But on it, it has some letters. This O right here is 15 inches from the tip of my bar. I have some customers that complain at 16. At 15, I do not. So I line that O up with this edge of the wood, rest my tip, and then I pivot to it. So let's fire this thing up. We'll do a couple. You guys can see it. Make sure you're in view here. Let me pause this. Alrighty, guys, we got a new camera angle. We get this round out of the way here. This thing is a monster. I love it. Love it, Aaron.
try this view.
No! All right, you guys.
I don't have a tape measure on me, but I do have a 16-inch masonry level. So we're gonna put this out next to the logs because it's pretty close to being what we're wanting. Put our finger at the first one, and we will see how close we are.
See how accurate my little method is. All right, so this one was way short, and I meant to do that because of the notch. So let's start here. Yeah, about 1 inch short. See if I can mark it here with my finger. All right, green side of my finger is the edge of the log. Little bigger. Little bit bigger. About the same size as the other one. That one's a little smaller. Another one a little smaller. That one's about perfect. Yeah, that one's a little big. That one's almost true 16. A little smaller. So all in all, I mean, I'm within an inch. I can live with that. None of them are bigger than 16. That's my important thing. So, let's see here. I'll set this on the ground. And it's smaller than the level. So, we do good. Good size stump. Good size rounds. And it's not huge, but like I said, this is a 28 inch bar. So at the widest part, I mean, right at it. I mean, with the big spikes, we'll just call it 26 inches. How about that? All right, guys, I appreciate you hanging out with me. I hope my little technique helps. I do want to remind you guys, I am not a professional faller. Don't go with my techniques for falling any trees. Just don't do it. You want to go fall trees and you want to learn, go find you an arborist buddy. Somebody will hang out with you, stand beside you, make sure you're safe. Never hurts, man. That one tree goes wrong, it could be the end of it for you. So, but I hope the firewood measurement technique is something you can use. If you're not into like pinpoint accuracy, it works out pretty good. All right, guys. Thank you very much. If you liked the video, subscribe. Like I said, go check out Aaron Lynch. Guy makes some awesome chainsaws, puts out all kinds of videos, great content. All right, guys. Thank you again. Like, subscribe. If you don't like, hit the thumbs down and maybe you'll like the next one. All right, guys. Have a great day.